And he already has 7 field goals to his credit this year. They're going to be holding it. We're just about ready to go. As Funk comes up, he's going to adjust that ball a little bit now. Back in the deep spots for Michigan, standing just shy of the goal line. On the far side is Jim Detweiler, and the near side, Carl Ward. We're situated on the western side of the field here. As the wind continues to blow, the referee goes down with a hand, and we're underway. The opening kick is a spinning one, taken over on the far side by Farabee, comes back to the 30, and is spilled out about the 32-yard line. Two on that play, second and 13 for the Wolverines. As they put it down now, just over the 27. In motion to the right comes Detweiler. Henderson's the split right end. Timberlake rolling off to the right, going back to pass, fires it upfield. Henderson grabs it on the 38, gets away from one man, still on his feet to the 40, and he's tackled down just over the 40-yard line. The guards, the linebackers, Kelly and Dreffer. In motion to the left goes Ward. A long count by Timberlake this time. Rolling to the left. Going wide around the left side. Gonna run, cuts into the 45, over midfield and into Ohio State territory on the 49-yard line. Getting off that pile first. Third and 15 now for Michigan. This time, Henderson is split to the left. As Emerson, Timberlake rather, rolling back. Going back to his own 40, he's going to pass. Can't find anybody free. He's going to have to run to the ball. Comes back to the 45, to the 50. Down into Ohio State territory at about the 47-yard line where he is brought down there. Kemp shifting into punt formation now. He's going back to about the Michigan 40. Dropping back along with Ryan now. It's like Tom Barrington on the far side. They're standing on about the Ohio State 10. Kemp pulls down the ball and gets off a high spiral. Coming down, hitting, out of bounds. We'll have to wait till they mark it. It looks like about the 19-20-yard line. Over on the far. Stan Kemp is standing on the Michigan 17-yard line. Double safety dropping back for the Buckeyes now. Kemp will be kicking with the aid of that wind this time. Gets the boot away. It's a high one. Catches that wind. Comes down to Ryan. He fumbles it. Back on the 23. Let's see. Michigan has recovered. And it's John Henderson down there to grab it on the Ohio State 20-yard line. Chuck, we've got our first big break of the game.
I think it's about time we got one. There's 1 minute and 19 seconds left in this half.
So Michigan will be putting this play in motion in a hurry now as the clock's still running. Henderson that time dropped on that fumble by Bo Ryan back on the Ohio State 20. Timberlake this time as Henderson's split to the right. He's going back. He's being hemmed in back there. Starts to run with it on the left side. He gets back to the 20-yard line. Spins forward to the 17. Nailing him over on that side. Crowd comes to life now as Timberlake has the team up to the line of scrimmage. He's going back to pass. Fires it down intended for Detweiler. He has it on the 5. And let's see. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Michigan.
On that particular play, Tom, Jim Detweiler from Toledo, Ohio, a fine sophomore halfback, lined up in the deep halfback position, went down over the middle to about the 5-yard line, crossed over the middle, and was hit by Timberlake, a play he scored on 3 times this year now.
Timberlake will be tempting the extra point. It's a big one. It's up in the air. A flag is dropped. The point is good. Offside Ohio State, refused by Michigan. Michigan comes back upfield leading 7-0. Four seconds remaining on that clock in this first half.
They usually have 3 to 4 or even 5 receivers going downfield. Woody Hayes is still a running coach.
Second and 10 for Ohio State. This time again, Umperford dropping back to pass. Fires it out to the left side. Stock has it, and he is hit immediately. There's a fumble, and let's see. Did Michigan get it before it went out? That's going to be the question as Stock fumbled, and Michigan's got it. What happened that time was Stock fumbled the ball after he had caught it up on the Ohio State 48. The fumble rolled down the sidelines. And there were two Michigan men over on that play, and they grabbed it just before it went out. Chuck, as Michigan has it, on the Ohio State 44. And Timberlake pitches back to Detweiler. Starts around the right side, goes to the 45, to the 40, down to the 37-yard line. And it could be Michigan's possession on the 36, second down and 2. This time, Timberlake keeping, running over the right side. He's got the first down, down to the 32-yard line as he followed his interference. Ward this time is set in the wing out to the right. The split left end is John Henderson as Timberlake turns and gives off to Mel Anthony. He's found a hole. He's down to the 25, goes to the 22-yard line as Mel spun away at the line of scrimmage from two would-be Ohio State tacklers. Finally bumped down for that first down as the handoff again is given to Anthony over the hole on the right side this time, and he's down close to the 16-yard line. This time following the interference over the... And it'll be a 32-yard field goal. Here it is. It's placed down. It's up in that direction. Let's see. It's no good. Off to the left, says the referee. So Bob Timberlake missing on a 32-yard field goal, and that will give Ohio State the ball now as they bring it out to the 20. The attempt came with 2:39 remaining in this third quarter. Steps into the ball, and here it is, a spiral coming down on the 50 taken by Volk. Back into Ohio State territory at the 45, the 40, he's away to the 35, to the 30, stays on his feet to the 25-yard line as Rick Volk brings that down to the 23 before he is finally knocked off his feet there by Tom Federle. Steve Geffer, the boy that did the punting. A fine run back that time by Rick Volk, giving Michigan first and 10 on the 24.
He and Rick Seeger were both back to receive that punt. Volk was thinking of signaling for a fair catch. Seeger yelled over, no, no, take it and run with it. He came over, gave Volk a tremendous block. He slipped between two Ohio State men and was on his way. If he hadn't stumbled, he had two blockers in front of him.
And the Buckeyes have been forced to defense it all of the time inside there with the pressure on. This time, Timberlake turns and gives off to Anthony. He's got a big hole, goes to the 15, scrambles down to the 11. As Mel Anthony, the bruising senior from Cincinnati, Ohio, finally chipped up back there by Dwight Kelly and Arnie Chuck. Right now, Timberlake's got him up to the line of scrimmage. He's got Detweiler set on the wing to the left. Henderson to split right end. On the bootleg, Timberlake going back to pass, looks into the end zone, fires it in there. It is almost complete, but just at the last moment off the fingertips of John Henderson. Henderson had his hands on that ball, just on the extreme outside edges, you might say. But he couldn't hold on. Roughly the 16-yard line, 16 and a half. Again, an angle to the left for Timberlake. Here's the snap. The ball is placed down. It's up. It's good! So Timberlake has come up with about a 26-yard field goal, and Michigan now leading the Buckeyes 10 to nothing. The long variety. The slot goes to the right this time with a balanced line for the Buckeyes. Umper for this time turns and gives off to his fullback, Willie Sander, who found the drive. Set in the slot to the right goes Ryan. Unpervert with a balanced line this time. Dropping straight back to pass. Running to the right. Yerby's chasing him back there. He fires it down the right side. It's intercepted by Rick Polk down on the Michigan 7-yard line, and he's down immediately. There's that big defensive play, Chuck Collins, that you were just talking about.
That's the thing is on that play right there, Unverfirth was rushed. He didn't really throw the pass. His end down there, Stock made one break on the primary pattern. Unverfirth couldn't throw it when he wanted to, so as a result, he had to wait a little while. Rick Volk had plenty of time. Unverfirth is a very fine passer. He's underrated. If I was Woody Hayes, I'd use him more.
They've got the slot to the right, and back he goes again to pass. Dropping back to the 27, fires a long one down here intended for Stock, and it is intercepted back there. I think it's Rick Volk. It is the second time today Volk has come up with a big interception. It's down on the Michigan 28-yard line, and Michigan will take over there, first and 10 to go. Pass from the Ohio State, roughly the 27, down to the Michigan 27, and Volk got up in front of the 10 and received. And Michigan, for the first time since 1950, come onto the football field as the champions of the Big Ten. And Bump Elliott coming out there onto the field along with the entire Michigan coaching staff with, I imagine, probably the widest ear-splitting grins that you will ever see on a particular coaching staff right now. And they're a mighty hilarious bunch of Michigan players down on the turf of Ohio Stadium. The Michigan football team has now gone into the dressing room, and they go in there as the champions of the Big Ten in 1964, the first time in 14 years that you can make this statement.